Hello, welcome back to my channel. Today I am going to do the beauty consumer tag and I'm kind of scared. This is really something that is, I don't know, it's kind of letting yourself be a bit vulnerable about your spending habits, about your collection. Yeah, it's just scary. But I really wanted to do this because I love watching the videos on this tag. And I was like, well, girl, if you're going to let everybody have their, you know, dirty laundry hang out, then you should go on and do the same thing. I have seen this tag by 90s Lovechild. 90s Lovechild is the one who started this tag. I've linked her video down below in the description box. Also her channel, because I wanted to give her credit for designing this gorgeous, gorgeous tag, because it's so much fun watching all these videos. I've watched one by Jen Love Reviews. I've watched one by Mel Thompson. I've watched one by Tara from Terrible Decisions, which was really cool to see because she did a no-buy year in 2019. And yeah, she had a very nice twist on it because it was very interesting to see how she was consuming before and during her no-buy, answering these questions. So yeah. Without further ado, just let's get into the questions. I've linked them down below. So if you are a creator, then please do this tag as well, because it's so much fun to watch for other people, but it's also very good for yourself to get some insight in your spending and beauty consuming habits. So yeah, let's jump into this, guys. Okay, I have got my laptop set up here. So I'm going to sometimes just look at my laptop to see what my answers are, because I have been really preparing for this because I think that would be handy. Okay, the first question is, how much do you spend on makeup a month and how much do you spend in a year? I was technically on a low buy this year and I started out with having 50 euros a month to 200 euros a month. I scaled it up a little bit and 9 out of 10 times I didn't meet that goal. I think I met it in October and September maybe, because I was on a bit of a, or even November, no, October, September and October, because I was on a bit of a no-buy because Black Friday was coming up. But I would say on average, I would spend 350 euros a month on makeup, and that would tally up to 4,200 euros a year. And maybe that is not a lot of money for a lot of people, but for me, it was like, oh, really, sis? Really? That is what you spend on makeup? Okay then. And I must say, this is also hair care, it's also skincare, it's everything related to beauty and looking nice and looking good and looking sassy for you or your man or forever, whoever you dress up for. But yeah, that was in a way a bit confrontational, but at the other hand I was like, okay, it's an amount of money that is a little bit too high, I think, during a year. So I am right now contemplating or just setting up my goals and rules for 2020. That video is coming up. So I have some thoughts and some feels about that number, and I think I'm going to go into that deeper in my 2020 video. But the thing is, and I think I saw Leah May, I think her name is, I'm not sure, I've just recently started watching her videos, but Leah May was saying that everybody has a hobby and everybody has something they really care deeply about, and for me it is beauty and makeup, and I don't spend a lot of money in other areas of my life. So I don't spend a lot of money on going out with friends. I don't spend a lot of money. I do, but I don't spend a lot of money on it. And I don't spend a lot of house stuff. I don't spend a lot of money on clothing. Shoes. My husband bought me shoes because he was like, okay, you need some good shoes and some nicer shoes, so here you go. Yeah, so for me it's like, it's a big number, but it's also, I want to put it into some sort of a perspective, saying that this is really the only thing I spend a lot of money on. But still, I have some feels about them. I'm going, like I said, I will be coming back on that in a few videos up in this month. I think it will be up in January, I just can't tell you when yet. And the second question is, do you ever feel guilty about how much money you spend on makeup? And I would say yes, because I know that my husband wants to buy a new car and we have to save up money for that. And if I would spend a little less on makeup then and beauty related stuff, then we would get to that goal faster. So sometimes I do feel guilty, but it's sometimes I'm at the other hand, I'm also like, okay, yeah, but it's just the only thing I want to do. And he has areas in his life where he spends more money on. It's just not the same amount. So I think I should meet that amount. It's a lot lower, so I should meet that amount. And the other thing is, what I feel guilty about mostly is that I notice that I don't get to use everything that comes in. And that's another goal for me for 2020, is to use everything I have in my collection right now. I want to use at least once. And that is not necessarily talking about mascaras or lipsticks or stuff that when you open it, it goes bad. So stuff that I can keep good longer with keeping it closed. I'm not going to put the rule on, but eyeshadow palettes, face palettes, bronzers, any powder really related beauty item, I think I should try and use more. But so that is some of my goals for 2020. I will have that coming up once again. So yeah, so I think that is something that I feel guilty about the most, is that I got a lot of stuff coming in and I don't use everything, or I don't use it within, if I don't use it within like a week, I don't think it's that bad. But if I don't use it in like a year, I think it's a problem. So yeah, that is something I feel mostly guilty about. And also the difficulty with spending money or more money on makeup than the regular person would is having a beauty channel. Now, I know my channel is very, very small, extremely small. I really hope that will change, of course, but I will have to put in the work as well, because yeah. But the thing is, if you have a beauty channel, you feel sometimes a little bit pressured into buying stuff, because I want to show you, because I want to use it and show you how it's performing, if it's any nice colors, you know, stuff like that. The thing is though, if you're really small, then it's not very sustainable to get every launch or get everything, especially with me being in Holland, that is just not a goal I should set for myself, because I would have to buy it online or in stores the moment it releases in Holland, or when I can get it to Holland. So if it has to ship from America, it at least takes 2 weeks for me to reach it. By then there will be I don't know how many videos already up about that product. So for me, it's not a sustainable thing to have a review based channel. And I think it's healthier to just, you know, be using the stuff I get in, really form an opinion about it. And if I buy something that is newer from a certain brand and I know the brand and I can really tell you, okay, like for example, Natasha Denona, I have bought a few palettes this year from Natasha Denona. I haven't been able to use them all right now, and the ones I have used, I've used a handful of times, so I don't know that brand enough to really tell you if something new from her comes out and I get it fairly quickly, if it is good, if it is something that is up to par for her brand, or if it's different, or if it's better, or if it's the same formula as this and this palette. So for me, it's like, okay, I just want to get to know my collection a little bit more, delve deeper into it, use it a little bit more, so I can give you proper information about the product. So another goal for 2020. Oh my gosh, I'm giving a lot away. I shouldn't be doing that. Let's go to the next question, because okay, do you get FOMO related to makeup releases? Major FOMO. I am the worst when it comes to FOMO. Oh my god. But I must say, I have given into this FOMO feel a few times in the past, and it kind of disappointed me. So most of the times it kind of disappointed me, the product, I must say. So I got it early, I got it quickly, and it was like, okay, yeah, I like it, but I don't need it right now, really. So I know this about myself. I know I have FOMO, and I know I get FOMO very quickly. But what I try to do is mostly stay away from products, one, that are limited edition, and are limited edition where I know it's going to sell out, like this, like the Jeffree Star conspiracy thing, the Star Wars Pat McGrath thing. I'm not even going to do it. I'm not even going to try it. Because the thing is, when it's limited edition, and you have to get it now. You get it and maybe you will get disappointed. So what I do right now is, yes, I get the FOMO feel, but I reel it in. I really reel myself in because I don't want to be disappointed. So if it's limited edition, fine. But then it has to be around for a few months so I can see a lot of reviews. I can see people I trust use the product. And then I can be like, oh, okay, well, now I really want to get it. And then I make myself wait for a sale. And because I've done this in the past with a few releases, I went off certain products because if it was up to me and my FOMO, I think I would have had like 5, maybe 6 Permacraft palettes by now. I have 0. I don't do it. It's the same with Jeffree Star. I really like his palettes. I really like the quality. I really like the originality. I really like the formula. I don't mind the price because I think it's up to, you know, it's a nice balance between the quality you get and the price you pay. And if it was up to my FOMO, I would have had like 4 palettes by now, more than I have. And I think I have 3. And I think that's good. That's nice. That's okay. That's a healthy amount. And if I want more, then I can always buy more if I want. And especially because a lot of the stuff isn't limited edition. So if it isn't limited edition, I make myself wait until there is a sale. And I think that has really, really, really helped me tackling the FOMO bit. So I do have FOMO. I am really bad at it, but I know about it. So I just reel myself in and I'm like, okay, I can't give into it. I just can't because no, I just can't do it. Okay, question number 4. Do you purchase or keep items simply because they are limited edition? Yes and no. Like I was saying before, the limited edition stuff has really gotten me quite annoyed with brands, and especially with like Pat McGrath, because she is so bad at telling you when she's selling stuff, when it's coming out, how much you will be stocked. So you know it's going to be a matter of minutes before it sells out. And it's the same thing with Jeffree Star, the conspiracy thing. That was not his fault, but I'm not going to go into this whole craze of getting that conspiracy palette, especially because there wasn't limited edition. So you know, I'm not even going to go into that. If I know a brand is going to get something out that is limited edition, that is going to sell out like crazy, then I'm not going to get into it. And especially because the stuff, you know, I have bought some stuff by, for example, by MAC, the Boom Boom Loom collection. I bought that stuff because I know I will use it. I bought one of the lipsticks because it was a very nice color. No, 2 of the lipsticks because those are colors I would wear. I got the MAC Fix Plus because I like MAC Fix Plus and I needed a new one. So I got that one because it was fun and it looked cute and it smelled nice. And I got the palette and I really love that palette. We didn't even agree on that, or we didn't even discuss it, but my makeup artist for my wedding used that palette. So I'm so glad I have it because she used it for my wedding, or my makeup artist for my wedding. I'm sorry, I should clarify. I don't have a makeup artist usually, but my makeup artist for my wedding used that palette. So then I like it. And it's the same with the Game of Thrones Urban Decay one. I've got the Besame palette from the Sleeping Beauty and I got the mirror. The question is though, would I keep it because it is limited edition? I don't think so. I think that if something goes bad, then I think I will get rid of it. Maybe not the Besame stuff, because there, a lot of thought has gone into that. And maybe not the Game of Thrones thing when it goes off. But if my MAC palette goes off, then I might toss it. Or especially maybe not the palette because of the... What am I saying? I think I would if there is some emotional attachment to it. So the Besame thing, that's just, it's Disney. There went a lot of thought into the packaging, a lot of thought into the whole aesthetic about it. The Game of Thrones thing, I think I will toss once it goes bad because it's fun. But you know, that I would toss. The lipsticks I would toss from MAC, the Boom Boom Bloom, and I would toss the bottle or try to reuse it from the MAC Fix Plus. But the palette I would keep because it's for emotional sake. So I think I purchased them not because the limited edition, but I And I don't keep it because it's limited edition, but I only keep it if it has some sort of a emotional attachment to it or if I really appreciate the craft. I think that's a nice one to end the answer of that question. The next question, number 5, is would you be willing to pay more money for a sold out product online? No. Flat heart, no. I would never do that. One, because I don't want to reward a person who has been hoarding a lot of makeup so other people couldn't get it to sell it for more, because that's just bad behavior. I don't like it. And second, makeup is expensive enough as it is already, so I'm not going to pay more money just because I couldn't get it. No, I won't. Okay. Question number 6, do you wish you could spend more or less money on makeup? And this is quite a difficult one for me because I really love to buy makeup. It's one of my biggest hobbies. It's something that gives me a lot of joy and it's really my zen, relaxing moment of the day when I do my makeup. So, and I really love to try new stuff. So I would, of course, say yes, because I would love to buy more products. And having said that, you know, I have a substantial makeup stash. It's not a stash that I think is getting problematic. It's not overwhelming me. I know sort of where the gaps are. I know where I should stop buying stuff. I know where I can buy more or can try more because I don't have something yet that I really, really love in that category. So it's like I could spend more. I wouldn't mind spending more. It's not something that is getting overwhelming. If I have stuff I really enjoy, I run out of them naturally, just, you know, organically, or I try to pan it, or if it's something that doesn't work for me, I try to give it away, and if it's just crap, I throw it away. So for me it's like yes, because it's not really a big problem, but on the other hand, no, because I don't think having a huge collection should be a goal in itself. So I think that the moment that will be something or that will happen for me, and this my makeup stash will get problematic in my opinion, and I will have to deal with it at that point. I think it's a good thing not to have an unlimited amount or an unlimited budget for beauty, because you, or at least I, have to really consider what I'm getting and what I'm buying and if it's something I really enjoy and use. So I think that is a good thing not to have an unlimited amount. But yeah, sure, I would love to spend more money. So it's like my head says no, but my heart says yes. That's kind of how I feel about that. Okay, number 7. Do you need or do you feel compelled to buy something when you see it in someone else's collection? I would say no, not necessarily because it is in someone's collection. I have a lot of YouTubers I really like to watch. It's not like, you know, if Angelica has something in her collection, I need to have it too. Or if Mel has something in her collection and I see she has it in her collection, I want it too because it's in her collection. So not necessarily because it is in someone's collection. But sometimes I really want to get something because a lot of people are giving raving reviews about it. Or not necessarily. I have a few YouTubers I really trust. So if, for example, Mel says that a certain primer is really working very well, then I would love to try it. It's the same with Angelica. She says, this indie brand has such and such a formula on their eyeshadows and it looks stunning and it's great and you can always buy something that's great from them. Then yeah, I feel like, oh, I want to try it. But I don't feel compelled. It's not like I'm like, okay, I have to have it or I have to buy it now. I just get intrigued and I want to get it and I want to buy it. So I don't think it's in any problematic way. Okay, question number 8. Do you buy more during the holidays? Absolutely. Absolutely. I even try to temper my spending a little bit in the months leading up to it, because I know I will be spending a lot more during the holidays. It's just a season for it. You have a lot of nice deals going around. You have Black Friday, you've got the holiday sales, but also you have to buy presents for people. You feel like you have to buy presents for yourself. I always have a yearly bonus coming in December, so I have a lot more money coming in. So I'm like, oh, I can spend it on makeup. So yeah, I do spend more during the holidays, but what I do now is I set myself a budget, I give myself a few rules, I make a wish list, that way I won't be spending too much. But yeah, I do spend more. True, I do spend more. Okay, question number 9. Have you ever hidden a makeup purchase from family or friends? Not not per se in like, okay, I don't want my husband to see that I bought this. But yeah, I sometimes I'm like, okay, I got this in and I put it in my beauty room right away because I just won't want him to feel like I have been overspending or that he feels overwhelmed because of all the packaging coming in. And he was like, and he would be like, okay, you're overspending and it's going to be problematic because I know how much I spend and I don't spend more than in my means. It's just trying not to alarm him because normally men don't really understand the costs really that involves beauty and makeup. And I think that they don't think or don't realize it is as expensive as it is, but also that it's not that problematic if you know what you're going to spend and if you keep yourself within a budget. So yes, I do, but not necessarily because I think he wouldn't approve or something like that. It's just a bit out of protection, I think. Okay, question number 10. Do you have more than 10 products in your collection that you have not used in over a month? Yeah, for sure. But I don't think that is really that weird if you've got a substantial makeup stash and you are a makeup lover. A lot of people have a lot more makeup and especially eyeshadow palettes and you don't use them every month. If you have like, I don't know, 200 eyeshadow palettes, you won't be able to use them every day or every month. So yeah, and I don't really think that is so much of a problem. I'm sorry, that's not something that is problematic to me. Number 11, have you ever been pressured to purchase something you could not afford or did not need? Well, that's kind of funny. I was thinking about it and I was like, well, not by anyone else, funny enough. It's just by me. I am the one who is making me buy stuff I don't need. And I can put the pressure on me thinking I need something or I have to buy something or I have to try a certain product. But no, not someone else, and especially not something I couldn't afford, or if I couldn't afford to buy something, I just don't buy it. It's, if I look back on my way, way, way younger years, like in my 20s, then yeah, I would buy stuff I couldn't afford even though I didn't really need it. But it wasn't because someone else pressured me. It's really because I was pressuring myself to get it, or just giving myself all sorts of reasons why I could and should buy it. Question number 12. Do you purchase makeup for collector reasons? Yes, I do. But only if I think I will get use out of it. There was a question about FOMO earlier and I told you I just make myself wait. And I did with the Melt Amour Eternal collection, I think it's called. The one with the skull. When I saw that for the first time, I was like, I have to have it. And then they had it on some sort of a pre-sale, I think. I didn't get it then because I didn't have any review, so I made myself wait. I sat on my hands. That was very difficult, but I sat on my hands. It released on Black Friday, I think, and then the FOMO cooled down a little bit. And I was like, okay, realistically, how much are you going to use it? So I really picked it apart, and I do that a lot if I think, okay, do you want this because you want this, or do you want this because the packaging looks cute, or because everybody has it, or because you want to have it as well, because in a few years time you can say, yeah, I got it and I'm on YouTube still and look, I still have it. So for me it was like, okay, dissect it, see if it's really something that you need in your collection, watch some reviews about it, and then see if you would need it. And with the Amour Eternal thing or collection, for me it was like, I saw a lot of reviews, I saw people raving about it, I saw it was such great palettes and so beautiful, so stunning. But the beauty of me seeing how these shadows applied, even though they were great, I was like, okay, yeah, but I can dupe this and I wouldn't wear it that much, because either I have these colors and I don't wear them that much and I can dupe it, or I don't have the colors but I wouldn't wear that much very dark deep red or deep blue eyeshadow anyway. So for that part I was like, no, I didn't get that for collector's reasons. But at the other end of that, I recently found out that the Prism palette is still on sale on the ABH website. So I wanted to have that. And that is mainly because you can see I have a lot of ABH palettes. And it's not like I want to have them all, but I want to have them all. So I got the Prism one and especially the ABH one. The Norvina ones I don't really care about, but the ABH ones I really, really like. So I got the Prism palette, it's on my way to me, and also the Carly Bible one that went on a great sale, so I just got that too. And that is mainly because that color story really speaks to me and I would really use that. So yes and no, yes and no. It's I do buy stuff for collector's reasons, but only if I think I will use it. Only then. We're moving on to number 13. In your makeup journey, have you become less or more consumeristic? And I would say less, a lot less. I don't really get that much FOMO anymore. If I get it, like I told you, I have a tactic of making sure that I don't go ham on the FOMO feels. And also because my collection has grown a lot, I know now a lot better what my preferences are, what type of brands I like, what type of eyeshadows I already have or don't have. So, and what I tend to reach for on a daily basis. So for me, I become, I think, less consumeristic, especially because one of my preferences is lying more towards the higher end, the medium and higher end brands. So if I want to keep up with spending on that level, then, you know, I've got to get a second and a third job, and I'm not really willing to do that. So I think definitely less. And I'm glad, I have to say. Oh my gosh, I'm already through this. I'm already through all the questions. Well, I must say, it was a little bit scary being this open to you guys. So yeah, I really, really enjoyed preparing for this video. Enjoyed seeing the questions and making me really think about them. In some ways, I think I have to improve on consume a little bit less. But on the other hand, I am quite proud of myself of how I'm doing this right now and how I am treating makeup and beauty. And I know that maybe some of you are watching me and you are like, girl, you're still in trouble, or you still spend too much money, or you don't really have a healthy relationship with buying stuff, or you buy stuff for collector's reasons and you shouldn't because it's not a collection. I get it, I understand, you do you. But I am quite content to say. And yes, I have a few goals that I've set for 2020 that involves me buying less makeup and spending a little less on makeup and stuff like that, or spending in other regions. And I have a video coming up explaining everything about that. So yeah, stay tuned and subscribe. Subscribe. Overall, this made me take a good hard look into my spending habits, into my makeup stash, my collection, or how I think about stuff. And I don't think I came out that bad. I think I did okay, and I think I'm doing okay. As I said at the beginning of the video, if you are a content creator, I would love, love, love to see your take on this beauty consumer tag. So check out the description box. All the questions are in there. I will try to link every video I have been enjoying leading up to my doing the beauty consumer tag. And of course, the video from 90s Love Child, because she's the one who originated this one. Thank you so much for watching. I hope you liked this video. If you did, then please give it a thumbs up and subscribe if you haven't already. I hope I will see you in my next one. Bye!